whisper, a sound on the breeze, dancing on the moonbeams and shaking the trees. From one single note to a chorus it done, it grows like your hope from the moment it's born.
Welcome to Let Your Heart Sing, here on World Radio, KHOE 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. I'm Sheila Moschen, and I'll be your host for this show number 85. We have a special guest with us today, Lawrence Eyre. Lawrence has been a certified teacher of Transcendental Meditation since 1976. In 1981, he became a founding faculty member of the Maharishi School and became the founding tennis coach of the Maharishi School in 1988. The United States Professional Tennis Association honored Lawrence with the National High School Coach of the Year Award at their World Conference in 2009, which I think is awesome. Congratulations, Lawrence. Lawrence is resuming coaching tennis at the Maharishi School after 5 years of coaching college tennis at Grinnell College in Iowa and Knox College in Illinois. He will coach the Maharishi School girls' tennis team this spring. Lawrence is also research director of the Fairfield History Film Series produced by Dick DeAngelis. When completed, this series will consist of 8 films that depict the history of Fairfield, Iowa, and highlight the amazing stories behind what makes Fairfield one of the most talked-about towns in North America. Lawrence wrote a haiku which captures the message of the project. When we drill down deep enough right here in this place, we reach shared bedrock. In addition to Lawrence Eyre's rich history with TM, tennis, and researching for the Fairfield History Film Series, Lawrence has an interesting musical background. He sang with the Yale Whiffenpoofs when he was in college. Let's chat with Lawrence now. Welcome to our show, Lawrence.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
So you used to sing with the Yale Whiffenpoofs, and I know our listening audience would love to hear all about that.
Well, it was certainly a delight to sing. I'll be happy to talk about it. Thank you.
Good. So what year was this that you sang?
It was 1969 and 70, so we were listed by graduation year as the Whiffenpoofs of 1970. So 50th anniversary, our reunion, is coming up in 2020.
Wow. I bet you're going to go to that.
Absolutely. We put on a concert every 5-year reunion. And it's a great opportunity to get back together with all the other guys in the group. This a cappella tradition's been around for 110 years now.
Wow.
And it's great to be part of history, I guess you can say, in terms of a cappella singing in the United States.
And you've also sung barbershop, I understand.
That's true. And in choirs, church choirs, and in school choirs. And back in the day in Moline, Illinois, I was born in Davenport here in Iowa, but I was raised in Moline. I sang in the Moline Boys Choir. And that was my first experience of four-part harmony, and it kind of became a way of life.
Well, you have a beautiful voice. One of the songs we'll be playing, you're the soloist in that song, and I was so impressed.
Oh, that's very
Because in a choral group, you know, you get covered up. Everything sounds gorgeous. But when you can have those soloists come out every once in a while and shine, and you shine.
Well, thank you. No, I appreciate it. My delight, to be truthful, is to sing in the ensemble, to sing in the group, because the harmonies that are literally passing through the horseshoe that we would stand in were exhilarating.
Yeah. Your musical background consists of mainly singing. Do you also play musical instruments?
Very little. Some piano lessons, and I did play drums back in the day, but I kind of reached a fork in the road, and singing took over.
Uh-huh. So the Yale Whiffenpoofs, as I've been listening to these many songs here on the CD, they seem to be mostly about love. They're love songs, mostly.
It's true. As a member of the last all-male class at Yale, I'm sure that was a topic on our minds, looking for love and happily finding it. There are a lot of songs, a lot of romantic songs from the Broadway tradition and from the earlier traditions that go all the way back to the middle of the 1800s, from the Glee Club songs like Aurelie and other things like that. They weren't on our album, but were part of our repertoire. Cole Porter, who wrote lots and lots of songs about such topics, was a member of the Whiffenpoofs in 1913, the fourth year they had the group. So I'm not surprised you noticed that.
Yeah, one song in particular that we'll play, like our fourth song, From This Moment On,
yes,
a Cole Porter song, to me sounds like a barbershop song.
Yes.
Because I used to sing with Sweet Adeline, so I recognize those kinds of harmonies. It's different from what you usually hear with the Whiffenpoofs.
That's true. There are 14 voices, and so we could afford, you know, to have a larger spread and more parts. We'd often break into six parts or seven sometimes. And then the soloist would have the melody line. I guess the way we'd look at it is putting those close harmonies together with just four parts, which reminds us both of Barbershop, was something we did on that song, because that's the way Cole Porter originally scored it.
Uh-huh. So are you singing with a group now here
I'm
in Fairfield?
Not. And I know Penny Minkler-Toke, God bless you, she always says, you should be singing, because Penny and I sang in the Yale Chapel Choir and for several years. And it's just a matter of time commitment. I'm still coaching tennis and teaching tennis. And, I did that. It's 30 years here now. I went away to college to coach for 5 years, but I'm back, and I'm coaching and teaching tennis at Marishi School again. And
Wonderful.
And I think,
welcome back.
Thanks. It's good to be home.
This is home, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Fairfield. You can go off here and there, but boy, this feels like home.
No, it definitely does. You're right, Sheila.
Yeah. So let's start with our first song called She's My Kind of Girl.
Right.
Can you tell us a little bit about that? I have a question about this song. It starts out in another language.
Right. It's actually.
And then it goes into English. And so tell me what that's all about.
Our pitch pipe, our musical leader, who was ingenious enough to become later on the director of the Dallas Symphony Orchestra, realized that the pitch ending one song could be the beginning pitch for another song. And when we recorded our album, they just spliced the two together. The other language is actually a marching in song that we would sing in our white tie and tails, marching into the auditorium and creating a horseshoe. And it would be separately sung and not part of My Kind of Girl, though on the album that's exactly what we did. We spliced it together on purpose.
But what does it mean?
That song was in two languages, and it was it was Czech and Swedish. And truthfully, it was a Swedish tavern song.
We don't need to translate
that's
it
right.
then. Okay.
People were very happy, and a lot of talk about romance, no doubt.
Okay, and then it breaks into that other song that were the familiar song.
That's right.
Okay, so we will listen to that now.
Okay, excellent.
One, two, three, smile. Anushka, Lushka, Shiroka, Rasta na mne trava, Rasta na mne trava. Anushka, Lushka, Shiroka, Rasta na mne trava, Visoka. Zora čistá je jako já, točí se dokola okolo Javora. Teče voda, zora čistá je jako já, točí se dokola okolo mňa. Zalita na nebe, paní, oběža nás mě, oběža nás mě. Zalita na nebe, paní, oběža nás mě. Czysta je jako ja, to czy z Docola, ocolo, ya vora te cebo da zora, ci sta ye ya coia, toci se docola, ocolo, ya. Elam goshum kapfala la 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 la, elam goshum kapfala la la la, against the meeker, helan tor on herrika, havan for.
She walks like an angel walks. She talks like an angel talks. And her hair's got a certain curl. To my mind, she's my kind of girl. She's wise like an angel's wise, with eyes like an angel's eyes, and a smile like a kind of pearl. To my mind, she's my kind of
face. That face just knocks me off my feet.
Pretty little smile, she really makes the day worthwhile. She looks like an angel looks. She cooks like an angel cooks. And my
I like the way they splice those two songs together.
Thank you.
And then now we're going to hear I Married an Angel, which has a soloist in the beginning, well, actually through the whole song, I think, and it's such a nice, sweet voice.
That's Richard Alfieri, and Rick was a really wonderful singer who went on to an acting career and then topped that by becoming a producer and director of movies out in Hollywood. Lori and I visited him once in Beverly Hills, and he invited me to drive his Jaguar, and I was petrified. He really had a lovely tenor voice. He was from a Florida product who ended up at Yale. And so I'm so delighted that you've chosen this song.
Yeah, it's lovely. Let's listen now.
Oh,
a nice voice that man has. And the next one is a song with an equally wonderful voice, except this singer has a deep voice, which is really, really mellow and rich.
This is Oren Persky, our bass soloist, extraordinary singer to this day, singing in the Israeli National Chorus. He was from Brooklyn, and I had the pleasure of standing next to Oren in our horseshoe. And a year after we graduated, I visited him and his wife in Jerusalem at Christmas. Oh. And in their very small apartment, we sang together, and I made sure to put shoulder to shoulder the same way.
Good. So now we'll hear Quiet Girl.
That's right.
Isn't that a wonderful song?
Yeah, Quiet he's a terrific
Girl.
Singer.
Yeah. Now we're going to hear From This Moment On. This is a Cole Porter song that we were talking about before, which sounds to me like a little bit of barbershop style.
That's true. The closer harmonies. We recorded this for a French national television special on the life and career of Cole Porter. Mm. It was in the fall of 1969, and they wanted reverb. They wanted, so we recorded it in at the music school auditorium, which is slightly smaller and really sonorous. And we went after it three or four times, and they said, "We."
Yes. It's a good song. So let's listen to this one now, From This Moment On.
From this moment, from this
next song is called One Note Samba. This is very different from the other songs.
True.
It's not really a love song.
No.
It's do-do-do all the way through, and it's got a good rhythm to it. I like it.
Yeah, the soloist stays on one note the entire time, and the song gets by with the shifting rhythms. And Scott Drum is the soloist. Scott is a businessman in the Seattle area to this day. He was a Minnesota boy coming to Yale. And I know he'll be delighted to hear that you've chosen this song.
Good.
This is just a little samba built upon a single note. Other notes are bound to follow, but the root is still that note. Now this new note is the consequence of the one we've just been through. It's bound to be the unavoidable consequence of you.
There's so many people who can talk and talk and talk, they say nothing, oh really nothing. I have been through all the skill I know, and at the end I come to nothing, oh really nothing.
So I come back to that first note, as I must come back to you. I will pour into that one note all the love I feel for you. Anyone who wants the whole show, or any possibility down, he will find himself with no show, and apply the note you know.
Just a simple samba, based on just a single. I will pour into that all the love I have for
anyone who wants the whole show, or any possibility dough. He will find himself with no show, better play the notes you know. He will find himself with no show, better play the notes you know.
Just a simple samba, just a simple samba, just a single, a simple samba.
So that was One Note Samba. Really great. And you mentioned that you visited him. You visited a lot of these people. You're in contact with your buddies from the Whiffenpoofs.
Yeah, and whenever we get together, it might be in the loft of a grocery store in Massachusetts.
Right.
for a lunch driving through on the way to Maine where I teach tennis in the summers, or it might be on a trip somewhere around the world. We always try our best and have managed so many times to get together to enjoy that harmony of song, but to enjoy the harmony of being together again.
And I remember when you came to Greenfield, Massachusetts, my hometown, and you and
Russ Thomas, another
who
of
lived
our bases.
Right near me.
That's right.
We all met, and Philip Tomlinson was there.
Yes.
And we met at the balcony of the health food store.
That's
Greenfield's
right.
Market. And we're having a great time, and all of a sudden, you and Russ just burst into song.
That's right.
It was fabulous. I think everyone loved it.
I know the people downstairs at the cash register looked up in astonishment, but and I hope in enjoyment. But in any case, we're going to sing whenever we get together. It's just pretty much automatic.
It was a very happy occasion.
Thank you.
Now, Lawrence, we're going to play one of your songs.
Okay.
You're the soloist here. You're a tenor.
Yes, first
tenor.
That's what
you are. And this is called, what's the name of it?
One Minute More.
Yeah.
It was written in about 1966 by a Yale student who was a senior named John Carney. And it was written from the internal dialogue of a painfully shy boy, who's trying to get up the gumption to say hello to a pretty girl.
Oh.
So the whole thing happens from within the complete nervousness he begins with to just about being ready to ask her name.
So now we'll hear Lawrence Eyre sing One Minute More.
Goodbye forevermore. half a chance of every day, the circumstance to make you stay 1 minute more. If you were to look my way and only blush and turn away, maybe then I'd find a way to get myself to say hello. Isn't it a lovely day? And maybe then you'd want to stay. Talk about the weather or a boy you used to know who looked like me.
Well, Lawrence, I must say, the audience is going to love the song they just heard with you singing. What
Thank
a great,
you.
Smooth voice. I love it.
Thank you.
Next, we have Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. And there's a soloist in here, too.
Yes.
It actually sounded a little bit like you.
Well, it's not. It is Rick Alfieri again.
From I Married an Angel.
That's right.
Oh.
And we were commissioned to do a version of this at the world premiere of Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
Really?
It happened in New Haven, Connecticut, and there was a Yale connection because George Roy Hill, the director of the movie, had been a Yale guy and a Whiffenpoof, in fact. And so we got an advanced copy of B.J. Thomas's song, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, and they said, have at it.
Oh.
So our pitch pipe, you know, William Harwood IV, who became the director of the Dallas Symphony, put together in whirlwind time this very ambitious vocal arrangement with the background, and then our very fine soloist, Rick Alfieri. So Raindrops Keeps Falling on My Head is for that occasion.
Uh-huh. So we're going to hear that now.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit those. Raindrops keep falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun, and I said I didn't like the way he got things done, sleeping on the job. Falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me.
But there's one thing, one thing I know.
Keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me.
What a nice version of Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. And now we're going to hear your signature song, the Whiffenpoofs signature song. Tell us about that.
Well, since 1908, which is when the Whiffenpoofs began, they've been singing this song every concert. It's by tradition the last song sung in the concert. And an invitation is always issued to alumni in the audience who from the Whiffenpoofs who might be present to join this year's group. And I had the privilege of doing that in Davenport, actually, a year ago in the 2018 group. It was sweet. I got to take my mom, who hadn't heard the Whiffenpoofs since 1969 when she visited our group. And she's 91 now, and she lit up like a Christmas tree at the occasion. So it's been an honor to sing, and it's fun to sing. And there are sonorities, I guess, that are on the level of feeling, as well as in the air with the song that come with this particular Whiffenpoofs song.
And you have a teeny tiny solo part in this of what, two words?
That's right. There's only a two-word solo in this song, and it's a transitional phrase leading into a chorus that I learned as a third grader in Moline, Illinois, where poor little lambs who have lost their way, ba ba ba. And the start of that chorus is the two-word solo. We'll pass and be forgotten with the rest.
And the actual words are, then we'll.
Then we'll.
So you can listen for that, listening audience.
There you go.
That's Lawrence. Let's listen now.
To the tables down at Maurice, to the place where Louis dwells, to the dear old temple bar we know so well. Sing the Whiffenpoofs assembled with their glasses raised on high, and the magic of their singing cast its spell. Yes, the magic of their singing on the songs we love so well. Shall I waste again my morning and the rest? We will serenade our Louis, our life and voice shall last.
Then we
pass and be forgotten with the
Well, Lawrence, this has just been fabulous having you on Let Your Heart Sing. I love your stories, and I like all the songs. Do you have anything more you'd like to add?
Well, I just, I had remembered while we were speaking about hearing the Whiffenpoofs song chorus as a third grader in Moline. The first night on campus at Yale, my freshman year in 1966, I heard the Whiffenpoofs sing, and my jaw just dropped at how wonderful they were. And I knew then and there what my hope was. There was no way to try out for the Whiffenpoofs back in those days. They just picked you. They tapped you, they called it. If you were going to be tapped at all, it would be in a Monday night in April of your junior year. And you had to hope and be in your room.
Wow.
Because if they showed up and you weren't there, you weren't in next year's Whiffenpoofs. So all 14 of us were the very grateful and lucky recipients of a tap in the spring of 1969. And they tipped us off, because it was the very last Monday in April, and they played the Whiffenpoof song on the Yale carillon bells from the big, huge tower. So I ran up five floors to make sure I was going to be home.
Oh, what a great story. You really lucked out.
I did.
But I know it wasn't luck. They knew that you had a good voice. Somehow they knew that.
Well, I did sing in a lot of other groups. We all did, and hoped that they liked what they heard.
Yeah.
I sang in the Russian chorus my freshman year. I sang in the chapel choir with Penny, mm-hmm. as I mentioned, for all 4 years. And then I sang in a folk group called the Augmented Seven for 3 years as well. And
so you just laid the groundwork
for
being selected. Congratulations.
Thank you. I've never regretted it. I can say that.
And thanks so much for being on our show.
Thanks for having me.
What a talented and interesting man Lawrence Eyre is. And we're fortunate to have him back in our community. I hope you've enjoyed our Let Your Heart Sing show today here on KHOE World Radio, 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. Have a splendid day.
Hurry down, sun down, get thee gone, get lost in the sunrise of the new dawn.
Hurry down, sun, oh sun, now, take this all day to set air.
Sundown,
we meet at
hurry down, sundown.